And this is the second part of number 77, No Attachment to Dust. And again, this particular section is simply lines from a letter of advice that a Tang master gave to his students. Here's the next one. A person may appear a fool, yet not be one. He may only be guarding his wisdom carefully. Everything has a place. Everything has a place in the universe. Everything has a place in our life. Every corner of our life is filled to the brim. When we, with our visual field, we look around, it's always full, always full. And when our mind is clear and open, the rich world of the senses is always full, always full. So there is wisdom and the potential for wisdom and loving kindness and the potential for loving kindness in everyone. Everyone. Because at a fundamental nature, it's always full. So we can recognize that truth. Each person has its own light. Each person has their own wisdom. But the appearance of someone is not indicative of that. We somehow think that the appearance of someone, when they're well-dressed, well-groomed, well-spoken, good manners, and have a kind of charisma, reflects wisdom. And it may not at all. It may not at all. So don't be deceived by the first encounter. In some places I've talked about the five Buddha eyes. The first eye just sees the surface of things. The second eye begins to see the emotional content, the emotional texture of things. The third eye begins to see the fluidity of things. The fourth eye begins to see the oneness of things. And the fifth eye is the functioning of all those other eyes. In accord with that, the next line is, to a sincere student, every day is a fortunate day. Time passes, but they never lag behind. Neither glory nor shame can move them. There is a koan in the Mumon Kan called Every Day is a Good Day. And monks are asking a teacher, they say, we're not asking about the 15th day of the month. We're not asking about after the 15th day of the month. What can you say? So they're asking about now. What can you say now? What can you say right about now? And he responds, every day is a good day. Now, what does that mean? Every day is a good day. Every day is a fortunate day. Obviously, in the world, things go up and down. There are easy times and hard times. There is strife and harmony. So on that worldly level, there is good days and bad days. There is bright, sunny days, and there are dim, cloudy, gray days. That's just the way things are. So if that's the way things are, that there is change, there are waves, there are good days, there are bad days, what is common? And what is common is we are alive. We are alive. Every day, easy, hard. Every day, bright or dark. Every day, whether it's a day of ignorance or a day of learning, is a day of life. And life is precious. Life is our most fundamental gift. So every day is a fortunate day. And on that fortunate day, in that fortunate day, we have the capacity to learn. So again, regardless of what happens in our life, we have the capacity to learn. So we have a sacred day of learning, a sacred day that enriches, a sacred day that expands, a sacred day that has the roots of loving kindness in it. So may your day be fortunate, and may it be fruitful, and may it be really satisfying.